Welcome to this special coverage of SSP Chaurasia Invitational 2023 presented by Take Sports. The event was held at the historic Royal Calcutta Golf Club, and here we present to you the highlights of the action-packed days. This was a special event in many ways. SSP Chaurasia is only the second professional golfer in India to have a tournament named after him. The other one is Jeet Milkha Singh. The SSP Chaurasia Invitational was launched in 2022 to honour the legendary player. Chaurasia is one of only two Indians to have won four titles on the DP World Tour. He is an Arjuna Award winner and two-time Indian Open champion. In all, he has 17 professional titles. Chaurasia also represented India at the 2016 Rio Olympics and the 2016 World Cup of Golf. To top it all, the RCGC is Chaurasia's home course. This is where he grew up as a player and learned his early lessons. There is a lot of nostalgia surrounding this place for him. The club itself has an illustrious history. It is almost 195 years old. The Royal is the oldest golf club outside the British Isles. It is regarded by many players as one of the most testing golf courses in India. It is also rich in biodiversity. Other than plenty of birds, jackals are also seen roaming on the course. This has meant that the venue and the event were made for each other. Chaurasia sounded emotional at the media conference before the event. He said it was difficult for him to describe how it feels to play in an event named after him, which is being held at a place he identifies himself with. The player thanked Mr. Srinivasan HR, Director of Take Sports, the PGTI and the RCGC for their support to this event.
Because I'm hosting this event and Mr. HR giving me opportunity to hold this event, and of course it's my home course, so I'm doing so many things, so of course I'm focusing my game also and I'm playing good.
However, it was a different experience for Chaurasia, the player. The conditions were treacherous on the first day due to persistent rain. SSP had a poor first round of 6 overs, 78, and eventually missed the cut by one stroke. This tournament got interrupted because of the weather on multiple occasions. As a result, the first two rounds took longer to complete.
The end of tournament was thrilling. It was anybody's championship until the very last hole. Om Prakash Chauhan displayed nerves of steel and exceptional skill to clinch it right at the end of an electrifying fourth round. This put Chauhan firmly on top of the Tata Steel PGTI ranking. He became the first player in PGTI's history to cross rupees 1 crore mark in season's earning. Varun Chopra of the US finished runner-up at the event.
The Tata Steel PGTI is known for the excitement it produces on the golf course. The competition is tough and that leads to some fascinating contests. A lot of events are decided on the last few holes. These are the moments that make this tour such a valuable learning curve for the players. This is where they understand what it takes to perform under pressure. The 2023 season has seen three tournaments decided in playoffs. The SSP Chaurasia Invitational also seemed to be headed for a playoff until a final hole birdie settled it in favour of Om Prakash. It was a pulsating finish at the charming RCGC. Rain on the first day was a dampener. But the action and drama on a rollercoaster final day more than made up for it.
This was a high-scoring tournament. In the end, there were just 6 under par totals. The weather and the testing nature of this course made it challenging for the players. This made the contest even more interesting. Well, sometimes high scoring events provide more thrill than the low scoring ones. This turned out to be one.
Rashid Khan and Udayan Mane were in touching distance. Ultimately, they finished tied fourth with tallies of 2 under 286. After the first two rounds, Mane was tied third and Rashid tied 11th. While Mane was steady throughout the tournament, Rashid moved up after a bad first round of 3 over, which left him tied at 23rd. This has been a so near yet so far season for Rashid. A 3-time Order of Merit champion on the PGTI and 2-time international winner, the player from Delhi had finished tied second in the previous event in Gurugram.
Rashid calculating that so beautifully.
He had another second place finish earlier in the season. In Kolkata, Rashid was in with a chance in the final round. After the difficult first round, he turned it around with rounds of 2 under and 3 under. When the play started on the final day, Rashid was tied fourth with a tally of 2 under. He was 5 shots behind Om Prakash, the leader, but just 1 shot behind the second placed Veer Alawat. It was not a great start for Rashid, but he managed birdies on the 9th and 12th holes. Some solid golf on the last stretch could have taken him close to the title, but he dropped shots on the 15th and 17th.
So he would certainly know what he's saying. Rashid knew where the ball was going.
That ruled him out of contention. In the previous event in Gurugram 2, he had made 2 late errors that turned out to be decisive. Mane's tale was different. He had a hole-in-1 in the third round, 2 over par rounds and a solid second round of 68. Like Rashid, he was also tied third going into the final day. But the 2021 PGTI Order of Merit champion found the going difficult in the fourth round. His A game deserted him on that day. There were 3 bogeys before he managed a birdie on the 8th. There was another birdie, bogey and an eagle on par 515 that gave him an even par score for that day. This was Udayan's best finish of the season in 15 appearances. His previous best was tied 10th at the Tata Steel PGTI Players Championship in Chandigarh.
Players coming back from poor starts was one feature of this competition. There were 9 in the top 10 who had over par first rounds, and yet many of them bounced back. Angad Chima's was one such story.
Things did not look good for Angad after the first round. Having carded a 3 over, he was tied 23rd. But he was right back in it with a second round of 5 under. This was the joint best round of the competition. Most remarkably, it was a bogey-free round. It lifted him to tied 5th. The player from Chandigarh had 3 birdies and bogeys apiece in an event par 3rd round. This kept him in the hunt. Heading into the final day, Angad was tied 3rd with 3 others. Angad started the last round with 2 straight birdies. His good run continued. After 9 holes, he was 3 under. This made him a contender for the title. However, Angad's last 9 holes didn't go as per plan. He made 2 bogeys and a birdie. He made pars on the last 6 holes. Chima finished with a tally of 4 under. This was too shy of the tally of winner Om Prakash. The sole 3rd finish was still the season's best for Angad. He has been really consistent in the second half of the season. He has 5 top 10 finishes in the last 6 outings. Despite not having won a title this season, Angad is 9th on the Order of Merit.
This is Steel.
And this is an idea. So what happens when we join them?
Something marvelous. Like cars that are lighter, more fuel efficient, yet safer. Thanks to Hyperform Automotive Steel, which lowers CO2 emission and makes this world a better place. Tomorrow is shaped by imagination,
and steel.
Tata Steel. We also make tomorrow.
Fruitnik Electro Plus. Rehydrate. Feel alive.
काम घर में कर रहे हों या बाहर या किसी बीमारी से उबर रहे हों, आप बिना जाने डिहाइड्रेट हो सकते हैं। रोज जरूरत है फ्रूटनिक इलेक्ट्रो प्लस रिहाइड्रेट। इसका अनोखा R3 फॉर्मूला इलेक्ट्रोलाइट रिस्टोर करे, ग्लाइकोजन रिप्लेनिश करे और मसल्स का तनाव कम करे तुरंत एनर्जी के साथ।
फ्रूटनिक इलेक्ट्रो प्लस रिहाइड्रेट।
Life with Vedika, always full of altitude.
पुरानी वर्सेस नई, कौन सी पेंशन स्कीम सही?
आपका हर सवाल सीधा होता है।
सरकारी नौकरी करे यानी कि देश सेवा करे, उसको पैसे देने की बात आए तो गुणा भाग और अर्थव्यवस्था समझाई जाती।
पक्ष या विपक्ष, सीधे सवालों के साथ संदीप चौधरी आपको रखे आगे। सीधा सवाल रोज शाम 7 बजे सिर्फ ABP न्यूज पर। ABP न्यूज आपको रखे आगे।
This has been an interesting season for rookies. Some of them have performed credibly. One of them is Varun Chopra. The player from Chicago, who plays under the US flag, came very close to winning a maiden title in his debut year on the PGTI. In the end, he lost by one stroke.
Varun clearly likes playing in Kolkata. He was quick to make his mark on the Tata Steel PGTI. In his very first appearance at this season opening event at Tollygunj Club, the 22-year-old had finished tied second. In his next appearance in Ahmedabad, it was a tied seventh.
You know, you'll see two youngsters, very athletic, and take on, his biggest attribute is his mindset. You know, his...
This is a shared experience and he doesn't get flustered.
Everyone sat up and took notice of the fact that here was a rookie who was ready to take on the top guns. This was followed by a none too spectacular period. In his next 6 events, Varun managed a best of tied 13th. He was coming close but not being able to break into the top 10. Back in Kolkata, this time at RCGC, Varun gave a glimpse of his potential.
Varun Chopra, so I'm sure he would like to change that.
The beginning was not great. Like many others, he played a round of one over. This was followed by an even par second round. He was nowhere near the leaders and tied 11th when the third round started. An impressive 3-under lifted him to tie third after day 3. Warren produced his best on the final day. He made a bogey on the third, but reeled off a hat-trick of birdies from the fourth to sixth.
He knows how to close it. Well, that's a nice one. A birdie there for Varun.
This gave him a chance of having a go at the title. He did not let another bogey on the seventh disturb his rhythm. There were 3 more birdies. After 11 holes, he had a day tallies of 4-under. For a while, he was the sole leader. Then came the heartbreak. Varun dropped a crucial shot on the par 4 14th. With 4 holes to play, he still had a good chance of edging out Om Prakash. But be it for lack of experience or the superior skills of his rival, Varun finished second best.
Oh my God, this is not a pretty sight. Varun Chopra is going to be pretty upset.
He went with pars and could not manage a birdie on the last 4 holes. This sole second finish should give him a lot of confidence. He was competing against a seasoned pro like Om Prakash, who is in the form of his life. Losing by one stroke will hurt for a while, but Varun can hold his head high. His performance was very credible for a player in his first year on this tour.
They say that champions save their best for the very last. And that's what Om Prakash Chauhan testified to on an eventful final day. He had an ordinary last round by his standards, but produced the birdies when it mattered most. That sealed his fourth title of the year. It was a thoroughly professional display from the most consistent player of the season.
Things were not looking great for Om Prakash on the last day. His 4-stroke lead was gone and he was not finding the birdies. A bogey on the 14th gave him a day's tally of 3 over.
And the way he's playing, you never know.
It's like he's carrying a bit of steam though.
Varun Chopra had caught up with him and even taken 1-stroke lead at one stage. It was slipping away from Om Prakash. He had returned subpar cards in the first 3 rounds. On this dramatic final day, things were just not working. A lot of players would have lost the plot out of frustration, especially after that bogey on the 14th. Chauhan had to get it right immediately. Then came that stroke of luck. Varun also dropped a shot on the 14th. This gave Om Prakash another chance. He pounced on it with a birdie on the 15th. With 3 holes to go, these 2 were locked on the same tally of 5 under. This was riveting stuff. The tension in the air was almost visible.
See, he drips it in.
Yeah. It's confidence. I think it's just confidence.
Om Prakash failed to get that birdie on the next 2 holes. Varun could not nail one either. So with 1 hole to play, they were tied at 5 under. It became a matter of who blinks first. Om Prakash then produced that master stroke. It was a birdie on the par 4 final hole thanks to a great approach shot. Chopra once again made par and Chauhan was celebrating.
Doesn't take too much time, does he? No one has birdied the 18th on the final day except the champion. You know, very deserving.
You can't say enough about this guy. It's not
what a tenacious guy. First Indian professional on the PGTI Tour to win more than 1 crore of rupees.
Champions have this ability to come back from situations when they are cornered. Om Prakash was in tight spot. The 37-year-old summoned all his experience and skills of delivering under pressure. This was the moment that mattered. Even though the 73 was his only over par round of the competition, that last birdie made all the difference.
Om Prakash Chauhan.
The prize purse of Rs 15 lakh took Om Prakash's season earning to Rs 1.13 crore. He is the first player in the history of Tata Steel PGTI to cross 1 crore mark in a single season. It was his 12th top 10 of the year from 18 outings. Player from Mau in Madhya Pradesh has won 3 of the last 6 events.
It's now time for the winner's speech, his 4th winner's speech this season. He's getting used to it.
My reason is that I changed my planning in the final round because जो मेरी प्लानिंग है वो अटैकिंग प्लानिंग है सो मैंने फ्रंट हाफ मतलब बहुत ज़्यादा अपने आप को चिल कर लिया था कि 4 शॉट की लीड है अपनी नॉर्मली गोल्फ खेलो कुछ नहीं है सो वो सही चीज़ है हाई प्रेशर में वही है क्योंकि नॉर्मली मुझे ये चीज़ कंफर्म हो रखी कि मैं हमेशा मैच फंसाने के बाद लास्ट होल बैडी मार के कराऊँ क्योंकि लास्ट वीक डिग बोई में मैंने वही किया था ईजिली मैच खत्म करने के बाद भी बोगी फिनिश करने के बाद लास्ट होल बैडी मार के फिनिश किया था देन खत्म होने के बाद मुझे जेपी ने मुझे यही वर्ड बोला यार रूपी तू मैं इतने टाइम से मैं तेरे को नोटिस कर रहा हूँ तो अपनी जो नेचुरल गेम है उसको उस पर फोकस कर तेरी गेम अटैकिंग है तू अटैकिंग के ऊपर अटैकिंग गोल्फ खेलना क्यों अपने उसमें सिंपल गोल्फ खेलता है
With 2 more events to play this year, Om Prakash enjoys a commanding lead in the order of merit. The gap between him and the second placed Karan Pratap Singh is almost Rs 40 lakh. Barring a major upheaval, Chauhan will finish the season as number 1 for the first time in his career.
What a fantastic event we've had this week. I guess it's a true test of golf. You know, this is a race for the title of the number 1 on the order of merit as the number 1 gets an exemption onto the European Tour the next year. So, well, there's a race on and I wish everyone the very best of luck. I'm sure OP's got a better chance, though he's leading by quite a bit. Some great playing by Varun, fantastic golf. Rashid, Udayan, Angad, I think some amazing golf.
This is steel, and this is an idea. What happens when we join them? Something magnificent. Like the Burj Khalifa, the world's tallest building, three times the height of the Eiffel Tower. An iconic landmark where Tata Steel's ComFloor 80 composite floor decking has played a part, making it a triumph of human inspiration. Tomorrow shaped by imagination and steel.
Tata Steel, we also make tomorrow.
Fruitnik Electro Plus. Rehydrate, feel alive.
काम घर में कर रहे हों या बाहर या किसी बीमारी से उबर रहे हों, आप बिना जाने डिहाइड्रेट हो सकते हैं. रोज जरूरत है फ्रूटनिक इलेक्ट्रो प्लस रिहाइड्रेट. इसका अनोखा R3 फॉर्मूला इलेक्ट्रोलाइट रिस्टोर करे, ग्लाइकोजन रिप्लेनिश करे और मसल्स का तनाव कम करे तुरंत एनर्जी के साथ.
फ्रूटनिक इलेक्ट्रो प्लस रिहाइड्रेट.
Life with Vedika, always full of altitude.
Tata Steel PGTI events are known for their highly competitive Pro-Am tournaments. They are hugely popular too. The Pro-Am at the SSP Chaurasia Invitational 2023 presented by Take Sports was no different. To add an element of fun, there was an exciting long drive contest as well the same evening.
The Pro-Am is a competition where three amateurs and a professional comprise a team.
At RCGC, Kapil Kumar and his team finished first. The amateurs in the Delhi Pros team were Mr. Rohan Sehgal, Mr. Ramanjeet Singh Chatta and Mr. Robindra Singh Chaudhary. His team had a total score of 54.2. Bangalore-based professional M. Dharma's team finished first runner-up. Their total was 54.9. The amateurs in this team were Mr. C.R. Chaudhary, Mr. K.K. Dujari and Mr. Aryaman Ghosh. Professional Varun Parik of Ahmedabad helped his team finish second runners-up. Their total was 55.3. Varun's team consisted of amateurs Mr. Kirat Parik, Mr. Binod Bansal and Mr. Ravi Kanoy. The straight drive contest on hole number 5 was won by Mr. Mayank Jalan. He landed at 10 inches from the line on the center of the fairway. Devansh Chadda won the closest to the pin contest on hole number 2. His shot landed 2 feet and 7 inches from the pin. The longest drive contest on hole number 18 was won by Mr. Rudraksha Banerjee. His drive landed at the distance of 288 yards.
It's actually quite a, it's a proud privilege to host this event, especially with SSP as the host. He's our member. On this occasion, I would like to thank a few people. First, PGTI, Take, thank you for bringing this tournament. And to my committee,
I'll start with the golf committee, Ranjit, who's here, the convener. He was responsible for the pro-am and trying to ensure that everybody got an opportunity.
There was an exciting long drive contest as well. There were three participants in the professional category. In the segment for amateurs, there were four contestants. Veer Alawat was the winner of the pro category with a drive of 322 yards. Abhijit Singh Chadha came second with an attempt of 321.3 yards. But do you know who drove the longest? It was Devansh Chadha in the section for the amateurs. He won the amateur category with a drive which went as far as 323.6 yards.
मैंने कभी नहीं सोचा था कि शायद मेरे नाम से टूर्नामेंट होगा और ये दो साल से हो रहा है सो ऑल क्रेडिट्स गो टू मिस्टर एचआर श्रीनिवासन सो थैंक यू सो मच सर थैंक यू फॉर सपोर्टिंग दिस इवेंट एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू नेक्स्ट ईयर थैंक यू
दिस वीक्स ऑसम एक्साइटिंग गोल्फ इन कोलकाता एंड द टूर नाउ मूव्स टू जयपुर नेक्स्ट वीक वेयर गोल्फर्स विल बी फेस्ड विद अ फ्रेश सेट ऑफ चैलेंजेस मोर ऑन दैट लेटर